Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to another video. Today I'm going to show you how to make your Discord server troll proof. Now guys, there is no way to make it 100% troll proof, and that's actually one reason I ended up closing down my server, just because the VPN space and privacy space is really toxic. However, that said, other communities are less toxic and less filled with trolls. However, in these communities, you still want to prevent them. Gaming discords, other kind of discords have a lot of good people in them, but even one troll can ruin an entire server. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to make your Discord server as secure as possible to prevent trolls from ruining the fun. Because after all, fuck them, right? So guys, we're going to be running through an entire creation of a server from start to end. So I'm going to put timestamps down in the description down below to help you guys out with specific things, but stick around for the entire video to help out the channel and support videos like these. If you like videos like these about Discord, let me know down in the comments down below. Also guys, if you want to help out this video and you haven't picked a VPN yet, VPNs are a great way to increase your online anonymity and privacy overall. You can hide your IP address, prevent people from finding your geolocation, as well as protect yourself while torrenting, unblocking websites, and much more. I've made the VPN tier list the world's first, and you can find pretty much every VPN ranked there. Additionally, I have other privacy recommended products down in the description down below, ways to remove your information from data brokers online so people can't dox you if they find out who you are on Discord. Additionally, I recommend a good anti-malware subscription, as well as private email, which is much better than Google and stuff like that. You'll find links for all the recommended and top rated products here on the channel down in the description down below. They're heavily vetted, not sponsored, just picked by me, even though they are affiliates. So guys, now let's get into the video. So guys, we have pretty much a brand new Discord server, and here's how we're gonna start things off. The first thing you're gonna wanna do is go here, click server settings, go to moderation. So we could go to moderation. Now guys, this is kind of up to you. Do you think your server is gonna have a lot of trolls, a little bit of trolls? It kind of depends. Are you making a new server? Have people been previously banned and you're making a new server? I honestly would recommend probably the highest level of verification. This means that if you ban someone, they're gonna have a harder time joining the server, even if they use a tool like a VPN to change their IP address. That's because you need a verified phone. You can make fake phone numbers with certain services out there. However, Discord is pretty intelligent about noticing these kind of numbers and even fake numbers on websites that anyone can use. Discord is pretty good at rooting those out. So I honestly would recommend checking that as a way to already kind of decrease the amount of trolls or people rejoining your server that have been banned already. Additionally, I would recommend scanning all the content here just to make sure no one's posting penises or anything like that in your Discord. So guys, another thing I would recommend is that if you don't want people messaging you all the time or kind of messaging you to troll you specifically and not in a public open forum, there is a privacy setting right here that you can disallow direct messages from server members. So this could be a good option for you depending on if you don't want people messaging you to troll you that way. I've noticed that's a very popular way for people to try to troll server owners is to message them specifically because they're kind of too afraid to do it in a public open space. Another thing you might want to do that isn't really related to troll proof, but just a good etiquette thing, is go to notification settings, click here, and then what you're going to want to do is suppress everyone and add here. You don't want everyone mentioning everyone. You can also change the server notifications, only add mentions, which means for people who are in the server and haven't changed the notification settings, they're not going to get beeped at every message. This is a good practice here. So that's pretty good overall to do. Now guys, there are some other things we can do in Discord before using bots and stuff like that, and I'm going to show you some of the things you want to set up. So basically what you're going to want to do is go to server setting, go to roles, and make a moderator role. This is a very important role to have, and you're going to have to pick some really good community members that can be trusted or pay to outsource other people who aren't affiliated with your community. This is a good idea to get unbiased moderators who aren't interested in creating drama, but you are going to have to pay them or find people who are willing to volunteer. So that's kind of up to you. Generally though, using outsourced kind of moderators can be a good idea if you're a really big community. However, if you're smaller, you can't afford to pay people, using community members who have proven themselves is a good idea. Just remember that moderators sometimes let it get to the head. They can moderate too viciously, or if you make someone a moderator and then take it away, sometimes they kind of throw a tantrum or they're upset because they don't have the power anymore. So just try to keep that in mind. So once we have created this role, you want to look at the permissions here. You should be giving them permissions to probably ban and kick people. You could do that here and here, as well as kind of look through these permissions and kind of decide what you want them to do. I don't think I would give them the permission to manage messages unless you're very confident in them. They could delete things or kind of change the narrative perhaps, but it could be a good idea if you're worried people are gonna put messages in the community that you want deleted. So that's something to think about depending on how much you trust the moderators. So now that we got the moderator role set up here, we can make a new channel for the moderator, and that's gonna be called the moderation channel. So what we're gonna do is do moderator chat. So this is a place where your moderators could chat. You're gonna do moderator chat, private channel, and restrict it to moderator role only. Not only that, but we could create a new category and make it private called moderation. Click next, go to moderator, and now we're gonna put this moderation chat in here, and we're gonna keep the current permission as it is. Another thing we wanna do is do unmod logs channel. This channel is gonna be very helpful for keeping track of what's going on in terms of moderation, whether people are getting banned, kicked, messages are being managed, people are, you need to look up stuff about a user, or just those kind of things behind the scenes that moderators need to see that other people might not need to see. So guys, these are pretty good for moderation channels, just in a basic sense here. And now that we've kind of set up this basic test server, we're going to start going into bots and those kind of things that can give you more tools to make your server troll proof. One of my favorite bots that is free to use is something called YagPDB.xyz. Now the name is kind of stupid, but the bot is really good, free to use, and stuff like Me6 is pretty good and has some cool things, but I've noticed that they're kind of really trying to push people into a paid model lately, and this bot here is a little bit more of a better deal, I think, since it's free and gives you a lot of similar features. So basically what you're going to do with this bot is log in, add it to your server, invite it to your server. That stuff is pretty self-explanatory once you go to the website. And then you're pretty much going to get to a page that looks like this. What you're going to do is go to moderation. And then this is where we're really going to get a lot of the cool tools here. So for this tab, you have kind of controls on like how moderation is put to users. You can enable this mute feature. You could have the bot manage the mute role, which is pretty cool. You could disallow reactions when muted. So if someone gets muted and you don't want everyone like laughing or something like that, that's a good one to pick. You can also have the bot ignore specific channels, like maybe like stuff like the moderation channels and stuff like that. All right, so we go to the moderation tab, and like I was saying, you could kind of control these different functions here, muting and stuff like that, enable kick. We want to enable ban, unban. We can make the reason optional as well. You could provide reasons. We also have a warning, which is kind of like creates a warning or something for a user. And these are kind of things you could kind of read about and customize a little bit more, depending on how you want each function to operate. So there are a lot of controls here, and that's just something you're going to have to kind of play with depending on how you want your server to be. However, basic auto moderator is a very good tool, and one of the reasons I'm recommending this thing. You could go ahead and enable it, and it's going to help you a lot with the server. You're going to have to kind of test it out and roll it out and see how it works and kind of adjust it as it goes. So one of the first tools you can do with basic automator is just enable it, and then we can kind of customize how it works. So auto moderator is very useful in terms of moderating your server without you always having to babysit it. It has so many useful tools, and we're going to go over each one individually because they each have really cool individual use cases. Slow mode is very useful for a server that has a lot of people in it or specific users who are always just kind of spamming or doing too much bullshit that way. You know, maybe they're posting too many memes. Maybe they're just being annoying and talking too much. This is a very useful tool. So basically what you can customize is how many messages someone can send within a certain amount of time. And if they violate these parameters, let's say 5 messages within like 2 seconds, then they will have a violation. And if they have a 1 violation, you can mute them, and you can customize the mute settings, like I said before, in the moderation tab. You could also customize the mute duration here. You could also have them kick after 2 violations, and after 5 violations of spamming the server, they can also be banned. So that is very cool, very useful. We also have mass mention, and you could customize it pretty much the same way as you did with slow mode. So if people are mass mentioning users or something like that, you can also customize that. We also do the same thing with server invites, links, banned words, which is really useful. You could customize your own separate words and you want to do it with separate them by spaces. So let's do something like this. That's pretty much how you do that. So yeah, pretty cool. We could also do the same thing with banned websites, and you could even do this, which will detect malware, scams, and other dangerous sites as well. So that's really nice. Really good if you don't want people posting sketchy links and stuff like that. Pretty much customized the same way as the slow mode function, which I covered in detail. So besides the basic auto moderator things with all these different functionalities to control, you know, warnings and stuff like that, we also have a couple other little settings, but I don't want to go into too much details about that. You can kind of explore around a little bit. But one of the most important things I think that you should take advantage of from this bot is the verification system. This is going to make it so bots can't invade your server. People are having a harder time, or will have a harder time, raiding your server, and that's this verification system. So basically how we're going to set this up is go back to our server like here, and we're going to want to create a verified role. And what we're going to do here is just call this role verified, and we could go ahead and save. And then once we have our channels, we're going to delete this basic channel here, and we're going to create the channel to be called just general chat. And this channel is only going to be available for the verified people. So anyone who is in the channel, we could also do for moderator in the bot as well. So only verified users that pass this captcha are able to view the actual channels. So that is what this is going to do. It's going to give them a little captcha that they had to verify themselves, and it's another kind of step on top of that phone verification to make sure people aren't raiding your server. Another trick I found out that when making a server is that people will join your server and sometimes troll the server or dox people by creating a username that kind of ruins the rules. So let's say my name was John Smith. Someone might make the name John Smith and put the address on there or dox someone that way, which is extremely toxic and against Discord TOS, but people still do it. So basically one way you can prevent that is by making it so the mod logs channel is where the new message when someone joins the server or stuff like this will be sent. So it's kind of an additional way to prevent people from being toxic or trolling by just creating usernames doing so. Definitely a little good tip there. Additionally, we want to create a basic channel here, just kind of introducing servers, introducing people to the server, and we can kind of call that the rule channel. Basically what we're going to want to do with this channel is make it so nobody can really type in it. And how do you do that? Well, you go to it and do this, so people will be able to read it but not type. And this is going to be the channel where you could write some rules, introduce your server, tell people how to become verified just by clicking on that captcha and stuff like that. This is a good introductory channel just to get your server off the ground and show people around. And then once they are verified through that captcha, they will be moved on to this channel and any other ones you want to make. Now guys, while I prefer using YagDBs or whatever you want to call it, I do like using Meesix alongside it, although I don't really like to pay for it. But if you do pay for it, there are a lot of cool premium features, so I do kind of like to use it in conjunction with the other one, using the best of both bots when kind of making a server, taking advantage of the best of both features when making a server. So let's go ahead and add Meesix to the server as well. You pretty much just go to Meesix website, Google that, add it to your server, and then go where we are now. So let's go ahead and go to the moderator channel. What we're going to do is assign the role to moderator, and here we can also make use of that mod log channel that we made. We're going to put mod logs to mod logs. We'll see all this information. We could even see when messages are deleted. Of course, like I said, these are going to be premium features, so that's something to keep in mind. We could also check some of these things, if people joined, user updated, left the server, if any things like that have changed. Auto moderator here in conjunction with YagDBA is going to be really good. You could also do this, warn member and delete it. Repeated text, do that as well. Prevent server invites, that's a premium feature. We could do excessive caps, external links as well. Also a premium feature. As you could see, some of these features with YagDBA were not premium. So this is why using both at once is kind of cool, because I don't think YagDBA has this caps features or the excessive emojis. So using both at once, it can let you kind of bypass some of these premium features. So we can also do this as well here. So excessive mentions could be good to put on. This would be good to put on. This could also be, well, we could just leave that for now. So this looks pretty good. We can also add automated actions depending on, you know, what you want to do here. There's plenty of customization available, guys. We also have restricted channels, so you could put the moderator chat, let it do whatever it wants. And also we have some commands here you could take advantage of with Mi6, clearing things. I think Gagdaba is like an exclamation mark clear, and Mi uses the slash commands. So tons of moderation tools here as well. Anyways, guys, this was a pretty good start for a good Discord server to make it pretty troll-proof. In combination with all those settings, you should be off to a good start. Let me know if you have any additional comments down below on anything you need help with, or any suggestions, or anything you'd like to see in the future, and I'll make that video just for you guys. Anyways, guys, see you in the next video very soon.